What's going on, guys? How's it going? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, the YouTube channel for dog lovers. Just trying to see how this thing works right now. Obviously, it's been a minute since I've done a live chat. Let's see. We're up and running. What's going on? Alright, I see you guys coming in. How's it going, guys? Oh man, what's up? Listen, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I know I promised like a video every day this month. I'm 13 days of straight videos. It's killing me. And I'm gonna let the room fill up a little bit before I go deeper into it. Looks like the sun just went in. Hello to everybody. Hello. Hey, you should have told everyone before. I know, videos every day is hard, but I'm working on it. It's not even so much the videos every day. You know, the thing about it is that I'm playing my life like, you know, I've been like single with no kids for so long. I really don't understand. I really haven't fully grasped how much time in a day my kids eat into my day. So I posted a video last night. I'm gonna apologize for it. I was working on it. I've been working on it kind of all week, and I had notes. And I really wanted to. I'm not reading the comments right now, just so you guys know. I'm not ignoring you guys. I just can't read and talk at the same time. And so anyway, this is the top 10 homestead protectors, and I had done all my notes, had everything. I literally rushed to get it done yesterday, and what I mean by that is that. I was up till about 4 a.m. finishing it, but I had it already like organized and everything. At least I thought I had it organized. Anyway, I know a lot of y'all gonna be mad at me. I'm mad at myself. I'm kicking myself when I read the comments this morning. So anyway, just understand from like 6 o'clock in the evening yesterday till about 3:30 in the morning, I was working on that video, finishing it. I had already done the voiceovers. Had all my stuff organized in terms of my research, my talking points, had the video, had the audio recorded. Did that earlier in the week and just decided that I needed to get a video up for Saturday. Anyway, to make this long story short, my intention in the earlier of the week was to put the Anatolian Shepherd and the Kangal on the same number. So it would have been 2 breeds, so it would have been 11 breeds. But yesterday, as I was doing the video, and I was just rushing, and my son's coming and going, and I forgot the Borble, guys. And I'm looking at it now, like, the audio's in there, the notes, just the notes were on the floor. I don't know how the notes got on the floor, but I never, it was like, it's like a 3x5 card or whatever. So I messed up, man. I messed up big time. Feel bad because the Borble was supposed to be number 2 or number 1. And like yesterday when I was going through it, I was just like, okay, well, Tibetan Mastiff, number 1, easy. You know, I was like, no Borble, Tibetan Mastiff, easy. So I think I'm gonna redo that video and I'm gonna try to post it tomorrow. Like everything is pretty much done. I'm just gonna redo it and post it I just dropped the ball on that. But anyway, like I said, you know, I've been 13 days straight. I've been posting videos, and I appreciate all the energy and love around the channel. A lot of things have been happening. I've been getting business opportunities. People have been hitting me up. So it's good things that are coming from it. I just haven't really had a whole lot of time. I'm not built for that right now. I don't have the infrastructure because I have so much, like, video footage that when I make these videos, like, I go through all this footage. It takes me hours to pick out the shots that I'm going to include in the video. And then I got to actually record the voiceover. Well, I got to outline it, do my research, make my notes, outline it, record the audio, then edit. It's a lot of work. But anyway, I'm not complaining because I get to do all that from my house. I get to take my kids to school in the morning, get to hang out with my dog all day. Ain't nothing to be complaining about. But I did want to apologize because the Borble is definitely one or two on my homestead list. It's one of my favorite breeds, probably like top 5 for sure. So I'm gonna redo that and either post it tomorrow or Monday at the latest. The idea though is that I'm going to do a video every day. And I realized, did you guys hear that? That is a thunderstorm coming. And I'm outside right now. So if it starts raining, guys, I'm gonna wrap this up real quick, especially if it starts lightning and thunderstorming. The crazy thing is though, I'm in about an hour or so, me and my family are going to the Dodgers game. So I hope the game doesn't get rained out. The Dodgers are playing the Nationals. You guys know I'm from Washington, D.C., born and raised. I grew up in, I've been living in Los Angeles for the last 20 years. So I kind of hold both teams equally in my heart. I'm definitely a Dodgers fan, but I always say, you know, I go with the home team first. So I'm a Nationals fan as well, even though when I was growing up, the Nationals weren't even there. But that's neither here nor there. So I'm going to, hopefully it doesn't rain too hard and we can get this game in tonight. I'm not able to look at your comments, but I'll probably do a live again tomorrow. And what I'll do is I'll announce tomorrow exactly what time I'm going to go live, because, you know, kind of creating a video every single day, going through all my footage to find shots and writing the text, the voiceover material, recording the narration, all of that stuff is like too much for me to deal with every single day. So I'm gonna figure something out. I'm gonna figure out how to give me some breaks. Plus, I haven't been able to go shoot. I didn't go shooting at all last week, and that wasn't a big deal because it was raining the whole week. So I'm not tripping off of that. What I'm gonna do though, I'm gonna read some of you guys' questions. We've been going for 7 minutes. I'm gonna read some of your questions. So if you said anything before now, you might want to say it again, because now I'm actually reading the comments. Can you make a video about the Tom Jack and the Pasavik Hound? I would love to. I mean, some of the things you guys have to realize though is that some of these breeds that you guys are asking for are very rare. I personally like to film all the dogs that I talk about on my channel. I personally like to spend some time with them. I like to spend some time with the actual, like, the breed expert, the person, whether it be a breeder or someone who knows a lot about the breed. So that's kind of how I do my videos. So a lot of times you guys ask for these rare breeds, and they're not accessible to me. I live in Southern California, and those breeds aren't here. In regards to the bully cutter, the Persian Mastiff, there's a good dude in Denver who I've been talking to. He's in Colorado, rather, who I've been talking to, who has 4 bully cutter. He just imported 2 from Pakistan, like last month. They're puppies. He says because of work, he won't be available to do anything until August. But he's guaranteed me that in August, me and him are going to connect, and we're going to do a documentary on his bully cutter. He has 2 adults and 2 puppies, which puppies should probably be almost adults by the time I get there in August. They should be at least 10 to 12 months old, I think. I can do this. What part of Cali are you in? I'm in Southern California, Los Angeles area. Can you do a video on the Lhasa Apso and Standard Poodle? I really want to do a video on the Standard Poodle and the Lhasa Apso. I'm less excited about doing that, but the Poodle, I really want to find someone that has this working with him. There's a guy out in Utah that uses his Poodles for as bird dogs. And that's kind of who I kind of fixed my eyes on doing a Poodle video on. But, you know, like getting to Utah is not something, it's not someplace I go every single day. And this print is kind of small, so I can barely read it. But the Alapaha is the Holy Grail, laughing, but Z already said those are the hard to find. Okay. Do you know any Pitsky breeders or anything with hybrids like that? Let's see. I don't know any Pitsky breeders. I don't know if my channel, I'm trying to get to all the pure breeds right now. I mean, I deal with things as they come to me. If someone were to have a Pitsky situation that was local and it was easy for me to get to, I'd probably do it in a heartbeat. But I don't know of anybody, and I gotta say, it's not like something that I'm like, that's kind of high right now on my to-do list. Really, right now, what's high on my to-do list is St. Bernard. I'm trying to find someone with a St. Bernard to do a video with. Huskies, Siberian Huskies. And we'll try to find someone to do that with. The standard poodle, but a working standard poodle. I don't want to go to somebody's house and they got the pom-pom poodles. I will probably at some point do that video, but it's just in terms of me, like, doing what I like to do. I like to get outdoors and film. I got some exciting news last week. I talked with this woman in California who has Jack Russells, and she actually hunts her Jack Russells in July. Right now, I'm tentatively scheduled to travel to Oregon. She goes up to Oregon and she hunts Nutria with her dogs. So hopefully that'll work out. That's early July. That would be probably one of my favorite documentaries to do if all goes well. So be on the lookout for that. There's something in that tree. I don't know if it's a squirrel or a bird or a raccoon. It's not a raccoon though, because it's not big enough. Can you do something on the pug? I'll look for to do something on the pug. I'll see if I can do something on the pug. The Tom Jack is a guardian dog. And the hound is very good ground. Okay, well, I'll look into the Tom Jack. Is that if I'm saying that right? Torn Jack, maybe, is what I'm... I can't really read it. It's kind of small. I'm on my for some reason, my computer wasn't working, so I don't know why. I updated the operating system, and maybe my encoding software is no longer good or something. Best way to introduce a puppy into bite work. The way I see people doing bite work with puppies is rags. They basically put them on a rag, see what their prey drive is like, and allow the puppy to go after the rag first, and then they bring it to smaller, what do they call those things, like wedges? I forget what there's a technical term for them. Just things for the dog to bite, but they start off smaller. But the first thing they do is rag. They kind of flirt pole it, you know, like put flick the rag around or whatever and see if the puppy goes after to bite it. Can you do a video on something to do with dog agility? I've done a couple of agility videos already. I've done one with a woman who did Akitas. She had Akitas and she did agility with her Akitas. And I did one with an Australian cattle dog. A woman had Australian cattle dogs. And so there's two agility videos up there. If you just, hold on 1 second, I'm sorry. I don't know what. All right, guys, let me see here. All types of coonhounds. I've done a couple of coon. Let me go back real quick. I'm sorry. Would you ever do something or benefits on crossbreeds or even mutts? My thing is, honestly, like, there's like this kind of assumption that crossbreeding somehow inherently makes dogs healthier or whatever. Dogs are only as healthy as the two dogs that made. A puppy is only as healthy as the two dogs that made it. So you can get two different breed dogs. If they're not healthy, then the puppy's not going to be healthy. So I'm not opposed to, you know, crossbreeding all that other stuff. I'm a bit more skeptical of it and just trying to figure out, like, who really is. I'm going to do something real quick, normal. Let's see if I do this. I can't seem to get this thing to go down. All right, let me see. All right, let's go back. Let's just use this. What I'll do is, if I'm missing your comment, I do apologize. I will go back once the video posts live or posts to YouTube. I'll go back and do that. The black mouth cur, there's a couple of people in Northern California that have the black mouth cur, and I will work that video out sooner than later. I've been trying to make it happen, but what does this do? Oh, I'm sorry, excuse me for playing with the phone. Let's see. Let me go back. I'm sorry. Again, I apologize. I'm doing this on my phone. Usually I would do this on my computer, but my computer was acting up. What's the difference between the Anatolian Shepherd and the Kangal Shepherds? I just did a video yesterday where I talk about it. It's, you know, basically size and a slight difference in working style and the temperament. But if you want a more full-throated explanation, watch the top 10 dog breeds for the homestead. I just talked about that. I just posted that video yesterday. Belgian Malinois or Doberman. Me personally, for my needs, I would go with a Doberman all day. Not that there's anything wrong with a Belgian Malinois. It's just that it doesn't suit my lifestyle. And I'm going to do a video. I have to construct it in my mind. I have to figure out. Let me just put this down for a second. I have to figure out in my head how I'm going to talk about it, how I'm going to do it, because I really want people to stop focusing on breeds and start focusing on breeders. A lot of people, you know, they say, I want to get this breed. What do you think about this breed? Well, the difference between a Connie Corso and a Rottweiler is, I mean, just in terms of the breeds, I mean, there's not much difference. But determining on how people are breeding them could be a tremendous difference. So I don't think you guys, I mean, if you're going to be, you know, if you're going to be on a higher level thinking about dogs, I wouldn't focus on breeds per se. I mean, breeds just basically really you're focusing on aesthetics in terms of what a dog does, how a dog works. You really got to figure out what your breeder, what the breeder's program is about and understand what it is that you want in a dog and what you're looking for. All right, let me go back. Sheesh. I guess I have to hold it. Are all types of pit bulls allowed in the United States? Some counties, some cities, some states have bans on pit bulls. My sister lives in Prince George's County back in Maryland. The last time I heard, they have a ban on pit bulls. What's up, Kelvin? I would like to see a video with Chico Lopez. I don't personally know Chico Lopez. I haven't met the dude. He seems to be a guy that does a lot of promotion and promoting. With people like that, I don't necessarily know that I need to do a video on them. If they're basically producing so much content themselves, I don't see the point in me doing a video with him. I don't. They're telling you everything. I mean, like Chico has. I know. Like I follow his Instagram page and. I don't really watch his YouTube videos, but I know he has a YouTube channel. And it seems in terms of like understanding what it is that he's about, he tells you, you know? I haven't met him, so I don't really know him. Or know whether or not I would want to do a video with him. But if you know him and you have something that you think is he has that would make sense for me to do a video on him, send me an email about it. I'm so sorry, Z. Caught in a thunderstorm and you're breaking up. I hope you do this again soon. All right, thank you, Ivan. I understand. I think I'm going to be caught up in a thunderstorm in a minute. In terms of game dog videos, I don't know. I mean, I don't know what the next story is going to be, what's the point of me doing a game dog video? It's like, do people really need, I understand like, you know, as a intellectual expression, game dogs are something to be talked about. I feel like in terms of what I would want to say about it, you know, having Richard Stratton talk about it, doing an interview with Richard Stratton said all I'd really needed to say. In terms of the documentary TV, I think that was had the best voice, the most comprehensive voice to say anything about game dogs. And I don't know what the next story would be to make a video about game dogs. I wouldn't rule it out, but I don't know what the next story is going to be. If there's ever, you know, ADBA show in my area, I always go and I film their dogs, which are mostly game dogs. So, and I don't know. I don't know. Send me some story ideas. If you guys have, instead of asking for a breed, send me a story idea, which basically means like, you know, the 10 greatest game dogs of all time. Maybe I can do a video about that, like figure that out. But just to like do another documentary on game dogs, I think the Richard Stratton video should be enough for everybody. Let me see. I'm having a hard time keeping track of y'all stuff. Some breeds for hiking. A lot of the breeds, like for example, a good hiking breed, you know, dog aggression. I need to do a video on dog aggression and all. There's so many videos. Sometimes I sit around thinking, like, what do I need to do? There's so many videos that need to be made, but I wouldn't even worry about dog aggression. I mean, there's some dog breeds that are very aggressive, for sure. I have yet to meet any dog breeds, with the exception, there are probably some, where some specific dogs where you can't, where a strong handler can't control their aggression. But some good dogs for hiking, I think, would be the Catahoula is a great dog for hiking. Any of the coon hounds, you know, maybe even the bloodhound. The only problem with a bloodhound is that they might be all over. Even the coon hound might go working when you get them out on a trail. I don't know. Maybe I'll do that. Maybe I'll think about that, and I'll do next, maybe this week or next week before the end of the month. I will do a top 10 dogs for hiking, and I won't rush my way through it. So I'll make sure that I get all the right dogs on the list. I do have a video on spay and neuter. You guys can check it out. That was done 3, 4, 5 years ago. I'm going to be getting a dog soon. I would not spay or neuter my dog before the age of 2. Just because dogs aren't finished. Their hormones haven't set in, but that's just me. Yeah. You know what I'm going to do, guys? I got to get ready to go because we are going to this baseball game. It looks like it's not going to rain, even though it sounded like it was going to rain. So I'm going to get off the phone. I'm going to get off the get off the phone. I'm going to get off of YouTube Live. This is going to be the video for the day. Unfortunately, today and tomorrow. Today we have the baseball game. Tomorrow's Mother's Day. I don't really have a whole lot of time to actually do the videos. So I think I'm going to go live again tomorrow. I'm going to figure out what time my wife is going to be doing her own thing. And I'm going to schedule it. So I will schedule I'll post tonight what time I'm going to go live tomorrow. Then that'll be another video for tomorrow. And I'll look at your questions, and I'll try to get to your questions in the next live. If there's any good questions that I didn't get to today, I'm gonna get to them tomorrow. And then I'm also gonna put something up in the community page. If you guys want to send me questions to the community page, you can do that as well. And I'll do tomorrow. I'll see you guys. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. If I didn't get to your questions, I do apologize. It's just one of those things. I'm doing this from my phone. I really would like to be doing it from the computer. But all right, guys, I appreciate you guys. Thanks for watching. The channel is growing. I mean, it's been growing. It's pretty big right now, but I want to take it to a whole nother level. And the community page is like a community tab. I think if I make a post to the community page, you should get a notice that I posted to the community page. So I'm about to go post to that right now. And you should get something. Especially if you have the notifications turned on, that's the bell on your on this channel page. All right, guys, thanks again for watching. I will talk to you tomorrow, and I will post as soon as I know, sometime today in the community page, what time I'll be going live tomorrow. All right, thanks for watching Documentary TV. Peace.